I'm Marquita, and I'm from Girl Scouts of Southeastern Michigan in the great state of Michigan. I'm a recruitment specialist, and I help troops get started. What is the difference between riding on a unicorn and riding in a car? You can imagine either, but you can only drive one on the road. Automotive design is thinking of new cars and other vehicles. A vehicle is a machine like a car, a truck, or a motorcycle that can move people or things from place to place. Today, you're going to design a vehicle. The activity covers two of the steps to earn the new DAISY Automotive Design Badge. You can find the full badge and the full instructions of the activity on Girl Scouts at Home. It should take about an hour to do this activity. First, ask an adult to help you print out the vehicle sketchbook and the DAISY vehicle diagram, which are shown below in links, so ask your parents to help you print them out for review. Then, you'll need to gather some materials. Two or more large pieces of paper, 1.5 small pack of white modeling foam, modeling clay or dough, some tools for sculpting, such as cookie cutters, rolling pins, dull plastic knives, or hard materials with patterns. Then you'll need a pair of safety scissors, scrap paper, markers, and a pencil. If you have it, you may even want to use tracing paper to help you sketch your vehicle. Creative designers are people who create new vehicles. They choose everything from the color of the vehicle to the shape of the steering wheel. Just like a creative designer, your challenge is going to be to design a brand new vehicle that can help a special customer. Have you ever heard of a customer before? That's a person who buys a product. To get started, you're going to choose from a product you can design from three options. You can design a Girl Scout mobile for older girls who are going camping, a mobile playground, which would be for kids to play, or a bookmobile, which is a mobile library. Once you know what your product will be, spend a few minutes thinking about your customer and how a vehicle might help them. It might help to pretend to be your own customer and see what you might want or need for a vehicle. Ask yourself questions like, where am I going? Why am I going there? How many passengers will there be? What do I need to bring with me? And you can even ask yourself, what do you dislike or like? What colors do you want your car to be? Now, pause this video for a quick drawing of your customer and any ideas for your vehicle on a sheet of paper. I know that I'm going to be making a bookmobile. How did it go? Do you have a better idea of what your customer wants or needs? I bet you have some great ideas to get started with creating your vehicle. Vehicles are made of a lot of different parts. Some parts are on every vehicle, like the engine and the wheels. Other parts are special, just made for that vehicle. These parts are called the design features. Design features help make the vehicle more useful, fun, or different from other vehicles. For example, customers may want a cup holder or TV screens for their passengers or people who ride in their car. A parent driving a minivan might want her doors to open or close by themselves. These are all special features. Once automotive designers have an idea of what they want their vehicle to do, what they want them to look like, and what parts and features they want to include, they create a list of design criteria for their vehicle. Criteria are all of the important things that the design needs to have, such as the parts and design features. Now, take a minute to look at the two criteria checklists in your vehicle sketchbook. These are a list of parts your vehicle needs to include. What parts do you see? According to your checklist, you will need to include a body. You'll need to include wheels, your doors, windows, a hood, and that's where your engine lives. You'll also need to include a trunk. And this is all for the exterior of your vehicle or the outside of your car. On the inside, you'll need to include seats, seat belts, and of course the steering wheel for the interior or the inside of your vehicle. Do you know what each of the parts does? If you don't, please check the DAISY vehicle diagram to find out. Now pause this video to add special features to your criteria checklist. For example, you can add special features to the exterior under the other parts, like the wheels and the hood on page 1 of the vehicle sketchbook. Then you could draw any other special features for the interior under the other parts, such as the seats and the steering wheel on page 2. Welcome back. After a creative designer has an idea for a new vehicle, they sketch a lot of different pictures of it. They'll draw the exterior or the outside of the vehicle, and they'll also draw the interior or the inside of the vehicle as well. This helps creative designers to think about every part of the design. For the next part of this activity, I want you to pause this video and use your imagination and criteria to sketch your vehicle in your vehicle sketchbook. Make sure that the sketch both includes the exterior or the outside of the vehicle, and you also include the interior or the inside of the vehicle. And you can see that I got started right away. I've been drawing mine. My exterior has my wheels, my body, doors, and windows. And my interior has seats and seat belts and my books for my bookmobile. If you need help on getting started, please check out the list of tips in the activity instructions. How did it go? Were you able to get all of your criteria in your vehicle sketches? Automotive design teams also sculpt models out of their vehicles. A model might be made of clay or wood or even a 3D printer. Just like a drawing, a model helps designers show their ideas to others and look for ways to make the vehicle even better. Next, you're going to be a clay sculptor. That's the person on the design team who makes the models out of clay. So pause this video and use your criteria and sketches to sculpt a model of your vehicle. Then, if you have the right time and materials, add color to your model and vehicle with markers. As you can see, I've started sculpting out my bookmobile with purple flower tires, purple doors that look like books, and also included my exterior features. If you need any help or ideas to get started, please check out the list of tips found in the activity instructions. Congratulations! You successfully completed 2 of the steps needed to earn the DAISY Automotive Design Badge. You've explored how creative designers like you can create vehicles that solve problems and help people. If you had fun doing this, you might want to continue designing and building vehicles with the rest of the DAISY Automotive Engineering 3 Badge Series. Thank you so much for checking out Design a Vehicle Activity. If you like this video, please share it with another girl and explore other fun activities at Girl Scouts at Home, such as the DAISY Entrepreneur Badge. And if you're not a Girl Scout, please join us. You can go to girlscouts.org to learn more. Thanks so much for watching.